G'day everyone, it's me, Vindictator1972. We are back with some more Orwell. Alrighty then, let's get started straight back into the case. Sandra Watergate. Hey you! Hi Jossie! Yeah, I'm gonna stop doing that, it still feels weird. Come on, stop. I can't seem to find my credit card, I assume you took it, right? You got me, Sherlock. I know I said I wasn't going to do it, I just automatically fucking did it again. I can't help it, it just automatically happens. I'm in the middle of buying all the bond in all of Bonton with that platinum card I lifted from your desk. Can't stop me now. Oh, lucky for you, I don't mind you going on a splurge as long as you pick up some wine for dinner. She stole a credit card of an unknown person. If you're able to find out who she was talking about, we could lock it for the owner. Wine, what does Joseph Langley, my fearless attorney and all-round badass, have in mind this time? Probably just a business call from one of his favorite clients. Actually, that is exactly what's going to happen. Very serious business, Cassandra.
I thought as much. Guess I better pick up shitloads of wine. You'll have to get the client of yours pretty buzzed to handle all that business.
One bottle should be fine. She's a lightweight. Colon nose pee. Oh, whatever, I guess I should pick up some of those party pills from Big Pharma, aka my parents, then. Oh, come on, I was only teasing. Speaking of your parents, when are you going to tell them about us? Yeah, maybe. Gotta go now. See, text you later. XOXO! Yeah, shut up. Yeah, she stole the credit card from a lawyer, really. Yeah. But yeah, like, see, it's there. It doesn't continue on with the rest of it, so they have no contact, which is brilliant. I am judge, jury, and executioner. Methamphetamine. Actually, some methamphetamine. Job is. I'm not really going to read all this unless we have to read stuff off a page, because it's just going to take us forever. Company! The name Watergate has been inseparable from progression and improvement of pharmaceutical research for more than 80 years. Watergate Pharmaceuticals is one of the nation's leading companies in the area of medicine, at the same time as the largest medication exporter of all areas of the world. The business Watergate Pharmaceuticals Corporation has been in the hands of Watergate family, owning and managing the firm ever since its foundation in 1931. Bruno Watergate, Chief Executive Officer, the CEO. The CEO of Watergate Pharmaceuticals Incorporated is Bruno Watergate, grandson and founder of the founder, Edgar Watergate. Apart from working in the family business, Mr. Watergate is also the founder of the Central Pharmacy Congress and head of the charity foundation, Children of Pages. Hey! Dr. Alice Watergate, head of R&D. Dr. Alice Watergate, co-partner of the firm with her husband, Bruno, holds a PhD in biology and chemistry. Good on her. Leading a double chemistry, mate. Bloody hell. I'm just going to stop talking. You guys can read and whatever voice you want, like Morgan Freeman, for instance. My personal favorite is Stitch. Well, it's a PhD in biology. She also leads research laboratories here at Watergate Pharmaceuticals. Cassandra Watergate, Jr., CEO. Carrying the family tradition to the next generation, Alison Bruno's daughter Cassandra will be joining the executive ranks. Her business acumen and unique flair will write the next chapter of our 85-year strong legacy. Now I see. Keeping it a family affair. Yeah, shut up. GCOO. I guess that's everything stays in the family. Documents that you have already reviewed may be updated from time to time as events unfold. The reader will notify you when that happens. The National Beholder just published a new article. You may want to have a look, see if there's any new information available. Fuck off, man. Is that actually the same person? I know, right? So different. The face is all different too. Job is. Alright, we are urgently looking for a new chief operating officer to replace the retired, formerly appointed predecessor. And it's just telling them what they offer. That's all I'm going to read for this page, because we'll be here for years if I start reading everything. Or maybe I was wrong and nothing stays in the family. Oh, shut your mouth, Symes! No shit it was. It really annoys me sometimes. Headlines. Crime rates continue to drop. The Ministry of Security has presented the latest numbers on the crime statistics in the country. Never before have there been so few violent crimes. Yay! De La Crox gives a press conference early this morning. Photo Ministry of Security. Bonton. On Thursday morning, the Ministry of Security published a new crime statistic report for the preceding year. According to the report, the number of recorded criminal offences decreased by 48%. In comparison to last year, the crime rates have been continuously declining over the past several years as a direct result of the implementation of the safety bill. Secretary of Security Catherine De La Crox appeared very pleased by these numbers and declared the development an outstanding result of success safety solution policy. God damn it. When confronted with the recent assault in Bonton, she once again admitted the ambitious goals of the government have not yet been accomplished. She further mentioned that that activities are currently being established, which have a considerable impact preventing further incidents. HOD. Alright, let's go look at the safety bill. This is pretty much our job. Party gets elected, and the safety bill goes in a sharp decline. Started declining anyway, but you know, it's like kept going down because it could have gone blip, 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 because civil unrest and all that shit. Alrighty then, the safety bill is the Pudge's peacekeeping mission. I'm not going to read all that. We'll read it later. I'm pretty sure we will. Procedure closing raises manipulation suspicions. Oh, fuck off. Yes, we've encountered yellow ones are special ones. In the context of two data chunks are at odds with one another, those are shown as conflicted. When you extract one of the data chunks containing a conflict, the other will be immediately invalidated. I recommend that you clarify the context of the conflict before you proceed. Though this is your decision, once the information has been passed, there is no way to reverse your choice. You know what? I'm going to go a different route, because I took this one. I wanted everyone in jail last time, and I kind of want to go a different route this time. Investigation into the malicious injury of a police officer has been dropped due to lack of evidence. Speculated that the accused parents manipulated the trial. It's not really conflicting information though, because it's one story, but you know, it's all about context. We don't get to give context, we only get to give the information that is highlighted. So you're pretty much set up to fail from the start. Driving the suspect's lawyer, criminal attorney Joseph Langley, photo GSTMB. The case that has been in the center of media attention for the last month has finally come to an end. Cassandra W. acquitted of the alleged assault against a police officer before the trial took place, with the case being closed due to lack of evidence. Yesterday, however, the case might be reopened should new evidence be discovered. Suspect's lawyer Joseph Langley, pictured above, welcome the outcome, blah 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 blah. People speculate that the family manipulated the events. I'm gonna go that one. It was closed due to lack of evidence. Yeah, nothing really helped in the case. Maybe it will today. Yeah, shut up. Yeah, she was radicalized. Let's find out what happened in between those two lives of hers. Maybe because we're shipped. Projects. Alright, it's highlighted, but we can't do anything with it yet. Probably because there's more information. Oh, Blaine. Hey, there she is, the bitch. Heh, we volunteered because we're awesome. Yeah, we go. That's something I forgot to do because you got to check everything to clear the stars. Alright, Cassandra's timeline. I am invited to see inside the rabbit hole. Let's go this one. I like that one. Actually, no, I don't. Let's go formal. If someone gets arrested, I'm swapping to an arrested picture because, you know, keep things easy. Oh, it's just all that. Right then. That's important information. That's important information. Shut up. Woohoo! First day in freedom, far away from the shackles of Watergate Pharma. Boy, it's gonna be too much to read. Alright. You've found the most, yes, very anti-governmental. January 29th. Let's disable this. Oh, I can't pass that on if it's disabled. Cool. Alright, let's do that one, because that's important to the case. We've already read that. Case is closed. You douchebag. You double douchebag. An alias name, you know, people on the web, so many names. Yeah, I have several aliases that I use. Alright, yeah, let's do this one. Because that's somewhat important, because it's an activist group. Here it is. My best friend, Mary. I'm going to get that one. I'll use the other one. Because the other one is the fuck you, you bitch. Blah, 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 blah. I'm a bitchy bitch. Alright then. I think that's it for timelines. Yep. Now we need to go to the listener. Hey, did you hear about the Freedom Plaza bombing? Yeah, don't remind me. You know I have a history with that place. Ooh, cold chip. I should have put the heater on between episodes. Really fucked fucking me up enough that I have to catch a bus from there every day. Too many bad memories, and now I was there just moments before this happened. Ugh, I never should have gone to that damn protest. Darling, you don't need to justify yourself to anybody, especially not to me. I was so happy when Goldfells accepted me into thought. I desperately wanted to go to prove my worth to be to the cause. She finds this. Yeah, yeah, I'll find out about Goldfells. Think of it this way. If you would not have gone to the protest, then you would never have been wrongfully indicted, and then we would never have met. Yes, and I would not have been called a terrorist or the papers. You are not a terrorist. Okay, ain't I? You sure? Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Oh, damn it. What? Car's not working here. Can't buy anything. Whoops. He's gone bankrupt or something. We got a car shut down. Whoops. Oh, that's right. Yeah, I got a thing shut down. Whoops. I shouldn't have stolen the credit card. Yeah, she's angry. Appointment here, appointment there, appointment every fucking where. How can you constantly do this to me? Darling, please, just calm down. Have you taken your methadone? That's actually important information. The only thing that matters is, you know, I'm fucking happy pills all day. Darling, please, it's nothing like that, and you know it. So keep your mouth shut whenever you leave me hanging. If I don't show up at this appointment, I risk losing a very important client. Fine, don't you understand that? She's a real fucking bitchy bitch. Hmm. I don't think there's going to be any more information from this call. I don't remember, though. Cassandra, you are not a fucking client. You are his girlfriend. And work is pretty important for the man. He's a fucking lawyer. It's how you could go on the shopping spree. Alright. I'm pretty sure a lot of these are going to be, locked. Yeah, they're all archived. Right. Freedom is on free. My catharsis. It's cams, cams everywhere, even at the Freedom Plaza. Is it just me, or is that a little bit, I don't know, ironic? Not really. Probably know me as either that blue-haired punk bitch, stupid cunt, or anti-governmental terrorist. These are only some of the names I've been called during the criminal investigation against me. That was just because in the middle of the chaos, someone believed to have seen me hurt a police officer. It never even occurred to anybody that it wasn't me. We are there because we wanted a peaceful protest. We have always been against violence. I gotta find that other case piece. Whoop, nope, go back. Alright, we already have a UTEL account. I wanna use that thing though. Freedom is on free. Hey, that's Goldfields. Boring. Not seeing anything. Alright, yep, cool. We read everything we needed to. Well, that we could read. Timeline's updated. Oh, for fuck's sake, you bitch! Alright then, let's just show conflict. I'm trying to play this one differently. This is probably gonna be bad for us. Yeah, yeah. Hey, she's talking to Jules now. Hey, Cassie. Hi, Jules. Cassie, just wanted to know. You're posting your timeline about this assault. You really shouldn't write something like that. Really, Jules? You can preach to me about this stupid post, are you? No. I just wanted to know what's wrong, Cassie. It's nothing. Just between the two of us. Just had us let off steam, you know. It's because of what happened, isn't it? Yeah, and lots of other shit today. Yeah, blue ones don't impact the story as much as yellows do. Something stirred up a lot of crap again, you know, what I did. What happened there wasn't your fault. Cassie, you hurt that officer to save me, and you succeeded. You mustn't forget about that. It was so brave. Fuck off! Fine. Yep, session's closed. Cool. Starting a new session. Thought about what you said. Maybe you're right. I should take the post down. It'd be better, believe me. Wait, somebody's at the door. Burp. Okay, I'll wait. Winky. Actually, that's a smiley face, not a winky face. Whoops. Putting emoticons in her mouth! That's not good! BT Dub, how is your boyfriend? You still together? You haven't been talking about him much that lately. Well, not as much as before. Hello? Is it me you're looking for? I can see it in your eyes. Are you still there, Cassie? Yeah, yeah, I did a good job. I am a god. Yeah, yeah. Cool. She's in custody. Oh, no. Secondary explosion. That is horrible. Two dead. Similar approaches, the same little found. So these assaults are connected. No kidding. No shit, it complicates matters. Yeah, I know we did good today. I'm good. What's going on? Headlines. No further information to gather. Matherin is an antidepressant. Fuck off. Alright, we've got all available information. Let's log out for the day. Yes, log out. Hey, you got an achievement, Ransom of Sorrows. What's this one? Show the peaceful side. Hey. I missed out on achievement because I didn't let her buy the bottle of wine. Alrighty then. Yeah, this is your summary day. You get all the information you pretty much gathered on someone. Like, all the important stuff anyway. And that they're a target person. This is global. Updates and shit. Based on the data, we've learned the following. Yeah, anyway. That's going to be it for this episode. When we come back to the next one, we'll continue the story. We'll see if we can fuck up any more of people's lives. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching. Bye. Boop, boop.